it's Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You know the drill. Let's get right down to it. About ready to get us going. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. Returnable here for Hester. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Carry now for Reggie Bush, and he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
On second down now, it's Bush, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher, third and six. Here's Michael Vick. He finds his man complete. That's Bush. And he's going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling. They'll run on first down. Bush, he'll get about four as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. This is Bush, and he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him.
He cannot get away. Down goes Vic.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. And fourth down here. That pass knocked away and incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Allen to throw it. Quick hitter here. It's complete. A gain of six there on first. Throwing again on second down. Allen. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down. Here's Allen. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There's pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him. And they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Allen will look to throw for it on fourth. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, but now it's first and 10. Allen. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Throwing again on second and 10. Allen, and this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. Darren Waller, there to make the grab. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. A post to the tight end for six. Gosh, those guys are so tough to cover, aren't they? Just in general, tight ends running those patterns near the goal line.
Because you have to decide how you want to treat them. Are they a wide receiver? Are they a big extra blocker on the field? Or are they a hybrid and caught in between? So are you going to use a linebacker? Are you going to use a safety? Are you going to even move a corner in if you're going to play nickel or dime defense? They usually win those matchups because they have an answer for all three of those positions.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. A give, this is Bush. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. A gain of three, second down.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that field like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled them up throughout the game because that was his longest run of this contest.
Third and short yardage. Vic completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third. Vic to throw on fourth down. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, but now it's first and 10. Now here's Vic. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Lorenzo Carter in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
Oh, he's got Hester complete, and he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. First and goal, Bush. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll try again down here with Bush. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Here's Vic, forced out to his left, throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Touchdown, Reggie Bush from 10 yards out. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Lutz good on the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. And how about this decision? Tie game, first half. But here's an onside kick. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Takes it at the 7. And he'll be
he's stocked up at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity to push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
And this one nearly picked off. Yeah, kind of surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but get away it does, and it's second down. To throw on second and 10, Allen. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Again. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Try and throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. On first down, it's Bush. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Vic to throw it. Dancing to his left. This one caught by Kittle. Touchdown, Falcons! George Kittle. As the first half is winding down, and the Falcons have taken the lead. So remember now, this was all set up by the stop defensively on fourth down. That's what got them this great field position. And then two plays later, they're already in the end zone.
Yeah, partner, funny how it works like that, huh? That's a momentum swing amusement park style. Your defense comes off the field, bouncing, grooving, they're fired up. And it carries over to the other side of the ball.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they will not really have time to do much of anything. 15 seconds, all that remains before halftime. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Give him 4 yards there, and that should be the final play of this first half. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And the Cowboys are able to recover. But gutsy call there. You exit the locker room with a lead. Tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
Allen now on first down. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Okay. to throw again on second down. Allen, a dump off to Elliott. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
To the air, Allen. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down, as that'll be a pickup of about five as they convert on third and inches. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. On first down, Allen. This will be caught, it's Samuel. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now Allen. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
Allen to throw once more. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Picked up by Pat Surtain.
And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. They'll go again with Bush. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? They'll try and run for the first with Bush. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And, boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally.
And all right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw, Vic. He finds his man complete. That's Bush. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Back now here on EA Sports. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Vic goes play action. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. It was Desmond Trufant right there, step for step in coverage.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
On second and 10, Allen. He completes it to Evans. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Throwing now is Allen. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. One final try here for Allen. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. The drive starts with Reggie Bush. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. Guess who made the tackle? Yes, Reggie White. Yards on the pickup there, and they've got it back to third and 10. A tight game like this, such a tough spot for the offense to be in, even though they have the lead, Charles, back up so close to their goal line. They got to protect the football.
And that's when you have to take care of your team.
And now off to the races, down the right side. On third and 10, they go flying past the marker and get nearly 40 yards. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked out before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. They'll keep it in the hands of Bush. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Vic. Able to haul it in is Kittle. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
This defense needs a big play in the worst way, because so far, they're not putting up much of a fight. If they don't get a stop here soon, this game could be over for them.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the 4th. And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's 3rd and goal.
trying to punch it across with Bush.
Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. So time runs out. It's a victory for the...
Conversion. You thought you had it, didn't you? You thought you had it.
Ezekiel Elliott. Yeah, we dominate today. ready.
The Jaguars will line up for the two-point conversion.
know they pay me extra for this.
Here I come! Here I come!
Ready? check mic 33. Check mic 33.
You ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing.
Mic check 33. 33.
Thank you. Let's go get him! 56.
Mike by four. Come on, baby.